Welcome. In this video, I will give you a brief walkthrough on how to calibrate a stereo camera pair with the SP1. Accurate camera calibration is a crucial step in stereo vision. Common calibration tools, however, can be cumbersome to use, which is why we have been working on making camera calibration as simple as possible. You do not require any special software for this task. Simply open up your web browser and enter the IP address of the SP1. This will navigate you directly to the SP1 web interface. Please note that the interface you see here is still in development and that it might differ from the finished product. If you wish to calibrate your stereo camera pair, just click on the Calibrate Cameras menu item. You will then instantly see a live camera preview. I have already pointed my cameras towards a suitable calibration board. If you do not yet have a calibration board, you can download a PDF version of the camera calibration pattern. Simply select your desired paper size in the drop-down list and click the download link. For calibration, we need to take pictures of the calibration board from different viewing positions. The more pictures we take, the better the calibration result will be. However, more pictures also mean more processing time for computing the calibration parameters. The SP1 currently allows you to capture up to 40 calibration frames. We can capture a single stereo frame by pressing the Capture Single Frame button. We repeat this process while moving either the position of the camera or the calibration board. A thumbnail of each captured frame is added to the preview area below. We can verify that the calibration board has been detected correctly by clicking on a thumbnail. The colored overlay that we see here indicates the positions of the detected calibration board circles. Should we be unsatisfied with a particular frame, then we can delete it by clicking the X button. We have to capture a few more frames in order to perform a successful camera calibration. For the remaining frames, we will use auto capture. In this mode, a new frame is captured in fixed time intervals. This allows you to move away from your mouse and keyboard to position your camera and calibration board. Simply press the Start Auto Capture button and press the Stop Auto Capture button once you're done. I have now captured a total number of 40 calibration frames, which is the allowed maximum. Camera calibration can now be performed by pressing the Calibrate button. Depending on how many frames you have captured, this process might take several minutes, so please be patient. Once complete, we are immediately redirected to the calibration review page. Here we can see a live preview of the rectified camera image. If we examine the image of the calibration board, we can see that its edges now appear perfectly straight. If we navigate back to the unrectified view, we can see that its edges appear curved due to the existing radial distortion. We can further verify the effectiveness of the camera calibration by displaying the epipolar lines in the rectified camera preview. A visible feature in the left image, such as this corner of the calibration board, has to appear at the same vertical distance to the epipolar line in the right image. On the calibration review page, we can further see all computed camera and projection parameters. If you like, you can download this information as a machine-readable YAML file. You can also re-upload a previously downloaded calibration YAML file. This allows you to easily switch between different cameras without repeating the camera calibration process. This concludes the camera calibration walkthrough. Thank you for watching.